Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. So this question belongs to GATE CSC 2015 set 2. Okay, so the given question is, assume that the bandwidth of TCP connection is this much. Okay, so they clearly give the bandwidth is equals to 1048560. Okay, so I don't know why they give in this way. Anyway, let us continue. Second, so let alpha be the value of round trip time. Okay, alpha is equals to round trip time in milliseconds. Okay, so after which the TCP window scale option is needed. Okay, so let beta be the maximum possible window size with the window scale option. Okay, so then what are the values of alpha and beta? Okay, so I think this is a type of a different question, right? Yes. So the first thing that we should understand here is we are in search of this alpha and beta, right? Yes. So alpha and beta equal to question mark. So what is beta exactly? It is nothing but the maximum possible window size. So the window size value they are asking. Okay. So if you recall, so including options. So they clearly told that including options. So if you recall, I clearly told you what is the maximum size, guys. So if you recall, we can take directly our 32, sorry, just give me a second. Okay, so we can directly take our 16 bits, right? Yes, so we are having a 16 bits for our sequence number. So just give me a second, I'll be showing you the diagram so that you can recall it. So we are talking with respect to TCP, okay, and we are talking with respect to window size, right? Yes. Okay, so what is the maximum window size, guys? It is 16. But if you recall, I clearly told that from this padding, we can take a few bits, right? Yes. And I also told you how many bits we can take, right? So if you recall, it is exactly 14 bits we can take from it, and we can make it up to 1 Gbps, right? Yes. Okay, so let us take that value only here. So basically with the options, you can go up to 2 power 16 into 2 power 14. So 2 power 16 is nothing but 65535. Into 2 power 14. So which option is matching the second part, guys? So 2 power 14. So option B and option D are wrong. Okay, so option A and C could be correct. Okay, so now we got that particular thing. Okay, so now the other part of the question is, we need to find the round trip time. Okay, so to calculate this round trip time, I think this method will be really good, guys. Okay, so the thing is, we know the bandwidth, right? In bits per second. Okay, and we know how much data we can send at any moment of time, right? Yes. So if you recall, how much data we can send, guys? So we always assume it as the original value, right? So basically, what is our original value? This is our original value. So what is this exactly? So that is our exact amount. So that amount, 65535. Okay, so this is in bytes, right? Yes. So let me write it normally. So this is nothing but a 2 power 16, right? Yes. So that is a nothing but, how I can write it, guys? So 2 power 6 into 2 power 10, that is a nothing but, 2 power 6 is nothing but 64 KB, right? Yes. So that is what, if I directly write it, it is a nothing but 65535 bytes. So if I want to convert it into bits, I need to multiply with 8 divided by my bandwidth. So what is my bandwidth exactly, guys? So my bandwidth is, it's some random number. I think there will be some relation. Sorry for that. Okay. Yes. Bits. Here also it is bits per second. Okay. So if I just multiply and divide it, what we will get? Let us see. So 65535 into 8 is equals to that much divided by 10, 48, 56. Okay. So the result is 5 seconds. Okay. So 5 seconds we got as answer. Okay, so is that true, guys, or am I doing any kind of silly mistake here again? Okay, so 5000 milliseconds is not there in the option, right? So just give me a second. Yeah, I'm obviously doing a mistake. So basically here zero is there, so it is 0.5 to be clear. Oh, my bad. So it is a 6, sorry, I'm really sorry for that, guys. 65535 into 8 is equals to that much divided by 1048560. It is nothing but 0.5. Okay, so 0.5. So 0.5 second is nothing but a 500 millisecond, right? Yes. So with that, you can conclude that option C is the correct answer. Got it? Yes. So this is a type of question which you can expect, guys, because these type of questions are really rare in examinations. Okay? Yes. So I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share, and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.